I believe we have to be thinking a lot more comprehensively than what makes people come to visit Vermont, and whether it's, you know, looking at a wind turbine or not. People come to visit Vermont, people come to live in Vermont because we have one foot in the farm field and one foot in the future. It's because we're a state that innovates, and we don't bury our heads in the sand and say, you know, we just want to live the way we always have. We recognize that climate change is a reality. We recognize that we have a responsibility to our neighbors, and we act. And even if it's on a small scale, it makes a huge difference when we look around the country and around the world. And, you know, I am proud, as Vice Chair of Natural Resources and Energy, that we have really tried to get out of that zero-sum game of, you know, is it going to be this land use or this land use, and say, you know, how do you shape a future in your community, in our state, that Vermonters feel ownership over? How do we give them some level of community access and control over their energy future and their destiny with the right information, while making sure that we are moving aggressively towards our renewable energy goal of 90% by 2050? And that is what Vermonters overwhelmingly want to see us do, and it's what makes our state great. Our bill, S-230, which came over from the Senate and was considered dead on arrival, or that our committee wasn't going to be able to get it out because there were too many thorny issues, too much disagreement, I'm proud to say 2 days ago was voted out of our committee unanimously and just passed through appropriations unanimously, because we listened to communities, because we had people who were anti-wind and pro-wind in the room, because we took everybody's feedback into account, and we said, how can we make this work so that communities buy into our renewable energy future? Because if we start to think that it's us against them, or that we're not going to be able to achieve that, we all lose. And we only win if we create that ownership, and we all buy into the solutions, and we have the ability to shape our energy future rather than be shaped by it and be shaped by the effects of climate change that we're already feeling.